student, myself Priya. I am going to deliver your lecture on grammatical topic for 5th class. Firstly, we will discuss what is noun. A noun is a name of person, place or thing. Nouns have number, singular, number, fourth one, and plural, number, four, more than, one. Again, I am going to repeat this definition. A noun is a name of person. अगर हम किसी person का name ले रहे हैं, place का name ले रहे हैं, या things का name ले रहे हैं, that's why we can say that it's noun. Nouns have number, singular number for one. अगर हम single person की बात कर रहे हैं, it's a singular number. And अगर हम more than one person की बात कर रहे हैं, it's a plural number. In simple way, we can say that it's naming what? For example, person, Mukesh and Dinesh, its person name, place, Mumbai and Delhi, is place name and thing, pen and book is thing name. Students, person Mukesh and Dinesh is person name, Mumbai and Delhi is place name, pen and book is thing name. Now we can divide noun into two parts. Countable noun. And second one is uncountable noun. Firstly, we will discuss what is countable noun. Countable noun students kya hote hain? Jinhe hum count kar sakte hain. That's why we can say that it's countable noun. For example, books, box, dog are the example of countable noun. Now come to the second part. And second part is uncountable noun. Students, uncountable nouns kya hote hain? Jinhe hum count nahi kar sakte hain. That's why we can say that it's countable, uncountable noun. For example, milk, sugar, stars are the example of uncountable nouns. Now, countable nouns are divided into three parts. Countable nouns are divided into three parts. First one is proper noun. Second one is common noun. And third one is collective noun. And uncountable nouns are divided into two parts. Fourth one is material noun. And fifth one is abstract. Now let's look into them one by one. Come to the first part, and first part is proper noun. The noun which denotes proper person, place or thing. It means अगर हम proper person की बात कर रहे हैं, proper place की बात कर रहे हैं या proper thing की बात कर रहे हैं, that's why we can say that it's proper noun. For example, proper person, Kirti and Komal. It's proper person name, place, Delhi and Mumbai. It's proper place name, proper thing, Gita and Bible. It's proper thing. Students, Kirti and Komal is the proper person name, Delhi and Mumbai is the proper place name, Gita and Bible is the proper thing name. Now, let's see how we use proper noun in a sentence. Come to the sentence number one. Jimmy is my pet dog. कि जिमी क्या है? मेरा pet dog है. So, in this sentence, word Jimmy is proper noun. Now, come to the second part. In second part is common noun. Second part is common noun. The noun which denotes common person, place or thing. It means अगर हम common person की बात कर रहे हैं, common place की बात कर रहे हैं या common thing की बात कर रहे हैं, that's why we can say that it's common noun. For example, common person, man and woman is a common person, common place, city and school is common place, common thing, book and table is common thing. Students, man and woman is a common person name, city and school is a common place name, and book and table is a common thing name. Now, let's see how we use common noun in a sentence. Come to the sentence number one. Ruhi and Rohan are brother and sister. Ruhi and Rohan कौन है? Brother and sister है. So in this sentence, what is the common noun? Brother and sister is the common noun. Now, the noun which denotes a group of persons or other creatures and collection of thing. It means अगर आप group of person की बात कर रहे हैं, यहाँ पर students हम single person की बात नहीं कर रहे हैं, group of person की बात कर रहे हैं, that's why we can say that it's collective noun. For example, army, crowd, bunch are the example of collective noun. Now let's see how we use collective noun in a sentence. Come to the sentence number one. I bought a bunch of grapes. कि मैंने क्या बोझ किया है? Bunch of grapes bought किया है. So in this sentence, word bunch is collective noun. Now come to the fourth part, and fourth part is material noun. Fourth part is material noun. The noun which denotes the material. We nouns जो material को denote करते हैं, that's why we can say that it's called material noun. For example, gold, silver, marble, tea are the example of material noun. Now let's see how we use material noun in a sentence. Come to the sentence number one. This plate is made of marble. ki plate kiski bani hai? Marble ki bani hai. So in this sentence, word marble is material noun. Now come to the second sentence. I purchased a gold ring. कि मैंने कौन सी ring purchase की है? Gold ring purchase की है. So in this sentence, word gold is material noun. So now come to the last part, and last part is abstract noun. The noun which denotes quality, condition or action. Students, the noun which denotes quality, we nouns जो हमारी qualities को represent करते हैं, हमारी conditions को represent करते हैं and actions को represent करते हैं, that's why we can say that it's abstract noun. Now for example, come to the example of quality. Yeah. quality. Now come to the example of addition. Happiness, illness, sadness are the example of condition. Now come to the example of action, judgment, movement.